We now ask you to switch off your mobile phones and stand to welcome our special guests to the auditorium.
Tēnā tātou katoa, ka timata tātou I te karakia, no reira, kēnui tātou. Manawa mai te mauri nuku, manawa mai te mauri rangi, te mauri ke ahau he mauri tipua, ka pakaru mai te pō, tau mai te mauri, haumi e, hui e, tāki e. Papakitu ana ngā tai ki mauao, i whakanukunuku hia, i whakanekeneke hia, i whiua reretia e hotu a wahine rua ki te wai, ki tai wiwi, ki tai wawa, ki te whai ao, ki te ao marama, ti hei mauri ora. I te tuatahi me mihi katika ki tō tātou matua i te rangi, nāna i hō mai, nāna i tango, ko ia te ihi, te wehi, te tapu, te mātāpono ngā mea katoa, no reira e te atua, tēnā koe. Ki ngā mate huhua o te wā, ngā mate keirungi a koutou, kia tūhono mai ki ngā mate keirungi a mātou, kia mihia, kia tangihia, kia poroporo akingia. Nō reira, haere atu rā, haere atu rā, haere atu rā. Rā taumā, kua whetirangi hia, moi mai, moi mai, moi mai rā. Kia tātou te hunga ora e huihui mai nei i tēnei ata, tēnā tātou katoa. Ki ngā iwi o Tauranga Moana e manaaki nei a tātou, ko Ngāti Rangi, ko Ngāti Rangi Nui, ko Ngāti Pūkinga, ngā mihi kia koutou. Kia koutou ngā tauira, ko tutuki pai i o wawata, anei te wā hei whakanui a koutou. Ki o koutou whānau, ngā kaitautoko, ko tai mai nei, ki te tautoko, ai ki te whakanui, i o koutou whānau, ngā mihi. Kui oku hoa mahi, e whakapau kahana ki te tautoko, a tātou ākonga, tēnei te mihi ki a koutou. Kauri rua taku kōrero i tēnei wā, engari ko te mea nui kia whakatau i a koutou, i a tātou katoa e huihui mai nei i roto i tēnei whare a tāhua, nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa.
Tēnā koe huia. Ko te pai tāwhiti whāia ki a tāta, ko te pai tāta whakamaua ki a tīna, haumie, huie, tāhikie. Tēnā koutou katoa, ko Leon Furi toko ingoa, nau mai, hara mai, whakatau mai rā. My name is Leon Furi, and I'm the executive lead for WinTech and Toi Ohomai business divisions of Te Pūkenga, the New Zealand Institute of Skills and Technology. And it's my privilege to welcome you, our successful graduates, your whānau, your loved ones, and our Toi Ohomai Te Pūkenga kai mahi to this graduation ceremony. Over 10 graduation ceremonies across Arohe, of which this is the last, we would have graduated 3,137 successful graduates from Toi Ohomai Te Pūkenga. We're incredibly proud of you. Thank you one and all for joining us to celebrate the wonderful achievements of our akonga. Before we begin the ceremony, there are just a few housekeeping items I would like to draw your attention to. In the event of an evacuation, it will be announced through the sound system. On activation, you'll be requested to evacuate the building immediately and walk calmly and quickly to a place of safety. The assembly points are through the door at the back and onto the grass courtyard. Please follow the instructions of the venue fire wardens and the Toi Ohomai event staff, who are dressed all in black. In the foyer is a screen for set up for live streaming of the ceremony. If parents would like some space with their little ones, please feel free to use this area, and our ushers can assist if needed. The ceremony would last about an hour to an hour and a half, after which we invite you to join us for light refreshments in the foyer. When the ceremony ends, staff on stage will leave first and form a guard of honor for our students, who will then exit dancing through this guard of honor. We ask the audience to remain seated until the students and staff have left. Swift and Click is yet taking formal photos before, during, and after the ceremony. There is no sitting fee, and the photos will be available to view online and purchase printed copies. Please do not approach the stage to take any photos, as it might interfere with the photographer's flash. You are more than welcome to take photos from where you are. Please do stay for the entire ceremony, even if your loved one is graduating first. Feel free to show your love and congratulations to your loved ones as they cross the stage by means of wahata, karanga, or haka, or any other means. It's such a special day for everyone involved. We encourage you to show your support, to show your appreciation and respect for those graduating. May I now please ask you to check that your mobile phones are on silent. The penalty for that is severe. Please may I all ask you all to be standing for the singing of our national anthem.
Come on.
What a beautiful national anthem we've got. It gives me goosebumps every single time. It is my pleasure to introduce to you our guest speaker today, Greg Pert. Greg is the founder and managing director of Transliquid Logistics, one of the leading logistic companies in New Zealand. Greg's journey to success has been a fascinating one. With more than 30 years of experience in the industry, he has built Transliquid Logistics from the ground up, starting with just a single truck and growing the company into a multi-million dollar enterprise. Greg has spent the majority of his career associated with bulk hazardous goods and tanker operations. This led to opportunities in the New Zealand fuel market, which was the beginning of Transliquid as a small fleet operator, providing a bulk fuel logistics and cartage service to Transliquid's customer network throughout New Zealand. With a strong focus on innovation, efficiency, and customer satisfaction, Greg has established himself as a leading figure in the logistics industry. His dedication and hard work have earned him a reputation for delivering reliable, cost-effective, and timely logistics solutions to clients across a range of industries. Without further ado, please join me in welcoming to the stage Greg Pert.
Transliquid has been established for over 20 years, providing bulk fuel logistics, bitumen logistics, and container cartage to our customer network throughout New Zealand.
We're an award-winning family-owned business that delivers on what we promise, and that's something we're incredibly proud of. For us, our team is everything, because with the right team, we can get the right results. Many of our staff have been with Transliquid since the beginning, and that's down to our company culture. In a nutshell, the calibre of our team is directly attributed to the success of Transliquid. We are proud to operate a modern Packard fleet of Kenworth trucks, which includes tractor units, semi-triaxle tankers, semi-quad tankers, 50 max B trains, and more. We chose these vehicles because they are premium in every aspect, and they're actually just as safe as most modern cars, with plenty of safety features that allow us to set the standard in our industry. Another big part of why we're successful is our emphasis on safety and compliance. We are recognised within the transport industry as a company that has established very high standards when it comes to safety and compliance. We'd love to help you, so if you need logistics or cartage, talk to us. If you're looking for employment, we'd also love to chat. The right product, the right quantity, right tank, on time, guaranteed. It's the Transliquid way.
Okay, thank you. Jason was a disc jockey and he presented that, and we won a prize from CoLab to actually put that video together, and we did it in a day. So Transliquid Logistics is predominantly a fuel-based company. Look, I'll just give you a couple of facts, really. Transport in New Zealand is the lifeblood. Road transport is. 93% of freight by tonnes is moved by road in this country. And globally, it's about 80% across the world. So, you know, the only thing I guess trucks don't deliver are babies, you know. So there you are. Pretty much everything comes on the back of a truck. We move a couple of million litres a day of fuel, North and South Island. We have about 30 trucks on that task. The bitumen trucks, we have about 15, couple for Higgins and the rest for Road Science Downer. And we operate about 5 Skelly container trucks that move bulk liquid and specialised tanks and some kiwi fruit to keep our guys busy in the off-season. Transliquid's owned by myself, my partner, and my son Gareth, who's an engineer. So he spent some time in the military over in Afghanistan, and luckily we got him back here. Anyway, Transliquid, it all started really from me. I was born on a farm, raised in a place called Kaiwaka up north, and we had to, in those days, our farm was about a mile from, our farm gate was about a mile from our home, and we had to walk to school or ride a bike or ride a horse if there was one available to catch the bus, rain, hail or shine. And we worked the farm. My father drove trucks in the off season to supplement his income. So from there, I guess that's why I got a love for machinery. So our farm life, I also became a good rugby player. And I guess some of that leadership skill when you become a captain of a rugby team in a small hometown, you learn some leadership skills to take forward when you move on. We moved to a place called Wellsford, and I went to school there, and I wasn't a great academic. I was more into sport, played every sport possible. I was good at woodwork and engineering, wasn't too good at maths and a few of those others. other things that you need. English, I was okay at. Anyway, moving fast forward, I became second year fifth, and I decided to leave school, and a mate of mine, we decided to travel to Australia because we thought that was the best thing to do. But we didn't last too long in Australia. We ended up in Perth, and we ended up deciding to come home because we couldn't make ends meet. So I came back and got my license, and I thought I'd go truck driving for 6 months. I ended up in a place, I moved to Auckland and worked for Freightways. At that time, we were a large company in New Zealand specialising in all sorts of transport, and I thought, oh well, I'll just do that for 6 months. And so I moved to Auckland, had no idea where I was going in Auckland at the time. They called me Farmer Brown because I was from the north. And so I immersed myself into that culture, and I found that I was really good at it. And so fast-tracking forward again, as we move into 1985, around that period, 1982 actually, they offered certain people in that company to become owner-operators. So I took on that role and bought a truck and ended up working in the tanker chemical side of the business. Now, for Freightways Bulk Services back then, I was 21 years old. You had to be 35 and married to actually get a role in the company at that time. So I was very fortunate to be a part of a growth period in New Zealand where we pioneered a lot of the way that transport was done, and I did it at a young age. And back then, you know, I was earning extremely good money, working really hard though back then. It was sort of 6 days a week, and we travelled away from home a lot. But that was part of part of my road to success in the transport industry. Look, moving on again, I took on a role in Morrinsville and carted hydrogen peroxide for an American-based company, and we had a truck that was hauling hydrogen peroxide through it. We were travelling 500,000 kilometres a year in that truck. We were doing over 10,000 k's a week. There was 2.5 of us operated that vehicle, running 24/7. And in 3 months, we'd clock up 100,000 k's, you know. So, you know, transport in New Zealand by road is so vital to our economy. That contract disappeared, and I ended up going back to Auckland, and I ended up befriending a guy with BP, and I got involved with BP, and they taught me the fuel business and the LPG business, and we trucked fuel and LPG throughout New Zealand. And then I morphed into BOC Gases and worked for them, carting liquid oxygen, nitrogen and CO2 and various products throughout New Zealand. You know, these are all skills that on the dangerous goods side of the business was really important. And I won a couple of business awards working for BOC, and it was it was a trip to Fiji, actually, that I took, and I met this is all by chance. I met a couple there that were on the Blue Lagoon cruise while we're touring around Fiji, and they said, "Oh, there's a company coming to New Zealand called Gull Petroleum. You should get in touch with them." So I got in touch with them, and I never heard anything back for a long period of time. And funnily enough, they did get in touch with me, and they said, "Oh, do you want to have a crack at this contract? We want to start up in New Zealand." And I, "Well, yeah, I'll give that a go." And so I didn't know whether I was going to get the business or not. So I went out and bought a couple of trucks, would you believe? And I had to borrow the GST money off a real estate friend of mine to buy these trucks. And he lent me the money. And so we had to write it down on a piece of paper, you know, Greg lent me the money in case he died and his wife didn't, I wouldn't pay the money back. Anyway, I punted it, and by chance, there wasn't a lot of trucks for sale at that time, and I thought, if I buy the track units, I'll be able to sell them. So I was extending myself. So I ended up winning that contract, actually, and luckily, paid the GST back and a few other things that made it all work. Built that from one truck. We built that, and I think it was about two service stations to about 100, there was about 120 or 130 outlets that we actually delivered to in the end. And some of these deliveries that we would do, we would transport a million litres or million plus litres to a ship like the Arctic P, owned by Kerry Pack, and we'd deliver that. We'd have a load delivered every hour on the hour, maybe from Auckland. So we'd deliver over a million litres to a bunker, just a ship, bunker a ship, for that's the amount of fuel that they need to operate. So we grew with Gull, and the business became very. When you start something from a greenfield and you build it to, you know every idiosyncrasy, you know your people, the values that our guys came up with, those values, and part of their training is all around those values. That's what ties our company together. We literally grew that business, and we operate. We have about 70 operators. We don't call them drivers, we call them operators. And we also own a service centre that is commercial. So across the company now, myself, my partner Jackie, and my son, we operate, we have about 100 people that work for us, and we're a flat structure. We don't have any sort of hierarchical, we just work together as a team, and management like myself, we're accessible. We know our people, we know their families, we know their birthdays, we know everything about them, and they know a lot about us. And that's the way that the business survives in a real corporate world that we operate, because we're only a family business, and we're up against some of the most wealthiest transport companies, corporate size companies, and we punch way above our weight to succeed in that arena. For me, I'm very operational. My son's more analytical, and my partner Jackie, who spent her years as a HS&E person for DuPont, brought a lot of safety to the business, which is, it's bringing everyone home. So today we operate a standardised fleet of trucks. Standardised means that we can, it manages risks really well for the guys. I mean, they hop from one Kenworth to another, and all our tankers are standardised. It just brings a simplicity of risk management to the business, and operators like that. Most of our operators, they would travel, they work, we have shifts, they work 4 and 2, 5 and 2, some work 4 on, 4 off. We've become quite flexible in our work, home life, health and wellness requirements for the operators and their families. We don't call our night shift the night shift, it's an afternoon shift, it's an evening shift. We pay our guys extremely well, and transport is not going away. The trucks that we operate are at the highest safety level. They have more features on than most modern cars, and there's a lot of acronyms that run with all those safety features that they come with today. All I can say to you all out there, if you're looking for roles or if you want to get into the transport industry, it's not going away. It'll be there for years. The freight task in New Zealand is going to grow another 40%. As we grow as a country, and there's some really good roles in the freight and logistics areas that you may want to look out for. It's a great business. We've succeeded well at it. It's a tough business, like most things are tough today. It's not easy. You just don't fall off a cliff and land on your feet in it. There are some hurdles, and we've had some tough times getting there. But we wouldn't be here today, and the people that work for us wouldn't be here today without us. So, one thing I always say to people, one qualification you must have today is a car license, and learn how to budget. I was never taught how to budget. But if the one qualification you need is a car license, and at least you'll be looked at by employers. Parting shot is safety is no accident. So I thank you for listening to me today. If there's any questions you want to ask me, feel free to do so. It's a pleasure that you're all graduating, and I feel like I'm graduating today just being here. Thank you.
Thank you, Greg. Greg, when you spoke about your journey and your business success, you certainly did that with a sense of passion, of determination, and a commitment to hard work. But it's interesting when Greg spoke about his employees, about his whānau, and particularly when you spoke about your son returning from Afghanistan, you did so with a deep sense of arawa, of pride, and a sense of heart. And despite all this business success that Greg has developed across his career, it's quite easy to see what's more important to him. And that's a key message for us all to take away here today. Thank you for sharing your story and for sharing your journey with us today, Greg. And I think the key piece that stands out for me, because the word hard work was used multiple times, is that the road to success is most certainly not easy to navigate. But if you do work extremely hard, if you've got drive and passion, and you build up resilience to want to make it work, it is possible to achieve those goals. It is determination that you should take away, the determination that brought you here today, graduating, is what you should keep with you. Don't lose that determination. Use that same sense of determination, of commitment, and of tenacity as you take the next step of your life. I wish you all the very best with that. Now to the formalities. I, Dr. Leon Faree, by the powers vested in me as executive lead for Toi Ohomai Te Pukenga, do now convene the ceremony to confer degrees and awards, diplomas and certificates to graduands both present and in absentia. To officiate in this capacity, I welcome to the stage from the Faculty of Primary Industries, Trades and Infrastructure, Faculty Dean Brian Dillon.
Kia ora, Leon. Tēnā koutou katoa. Great to see so many of you here today. The Faculty of Primary Industries, Trades and Infrastructure covers more than 11 industry sectors, very practical and applied by its nature, and that's reflected in what we teach and how we teach it. Our faculty works with more than 4,000 students every year, with about 70% of those studying part-time, anywhere from a two-hour trade refresher to a four-year cadetship or apprenticeship. Others study full-time to prepare for a vocation or perhaps retrain. And we have about 600 students coming to us from the secondary school sector every year to help them prepare for a vocational career. To sum up our faculty, we're in this business of designing and building, diagnosing and fixing, growing and shifting. So you can use your imagination and get a pretty good sense of what we're doing there. Just before we actually start the presentation departments, just want to acknowledge your story, Greg, and thanks for sharing it with us. And I know that there are dozens of stories across the country that are related to those 11, more than 11 sectors that we work with that have a similar element to them. Giving something a go, working hard and making a success of it. We're now going to present certificates and diplomas to our graduates that are here today. I will invite our kaaka or tutor up to the stage in front of the banner. I will then announce the program, which is the awarding the parchments for, and then invite the graduates across one by one. And that's the time where we can have hooping and hollering and cheering and clapping, whatever you want to do for your loved one. For the graduates, make your way across to the red dot on the stage and then be handed the parchment and making sure that you smile for the photographer as well. If I can invite Eli Crawshaw up to the stage, please. Eli's going to present parchments for our first program today, which is the New Zealand Certificate in Automotive Engineering Level 3. And our first graduate is Isaac Bain. Blair Herford. Bethany Leseleur. Toi Miller. Levi Rumble. Star Tahoe. Thank you, Eli. If I could ask Sue Brotherton to come to the stage, please. Sue's going to present parchments for the New Zealand Certificate in Construction Trade Skills Level 3. Our first graduate is Gerson Venegas Villegas. Gerson's actually graduating with two qualifications today, as well as the construction one. He's completed the New Zealand Certificate in Commercial Road Transport, Heavy Vehicle Operator Level 3. So Gerson was the only graduate here today from Class 1. We've got three graduates from Class 2 of that same program. The first one from Class 2 is Stevie Ray Angell. Jacob Clayton. Oliver Clayton. Thanks, Sue. Could we have Brett Jimison to the stage, please? Brett's going to present parchments for two qualifications, both related to carpentry. The first one is the National Certificate in Carpentry Level 4, so that qualification is what we call teach-out phase. Just the one graduate today for that one, Timothy Walker. And for the new version of the qualification, the New Zealand Certificate in Carpentry Level 4, Jonah Manu. Ian Wishart. Ian, can you come up to the stage, please? Ian's going to present parchments for the New Zealand Diploma in Architectural Technology Level 6. Our first graduate, Fernando Besson. Nathan Bergen. Emma Diprose. William Gommons. Savannah Gulliver. Helly McIntosh. Monica Mariscalchi. Campbell McMillan. Amber McQuillan. Douglas Mitchell. Caitlin O'Brien. Jessica O'Hearn. Michaela Roberts. Yeah. Ben Whittaker. Cassandra Whiteley. Thank you, Ian. We can invite Chris Prigg to the stage, please. Chris is going to present parchments for the New Zealand Diploma in Construction Level 6. And the first graduate is the recipient of the Construction Management Strand, Ryan Tesselaar. The next graduates are graduating with the New Zealand Diploma in Construction Level 6 Quantity Surveying, Francois Bester. G. Gao. Regan Jordan. Sean Little. Vijay Kumar Prajapati. Jared Sloan. Bing Sun. Nathan Wansborough. Pretty exciting, huh? Hannah Wilkinson. Hannah's, as well as her construction quantity surveying diploma, Hannah is also graduating with Te Pōkai Tahi Rua Māori Rua Rura Kaupai 2. Well done, Hannah. Tianzi Zhou. Thanks, Chris. Can I ask Rachel Beaton to come up, please? Rachel's going to present parchments for the New Zealand Diploma in Surveying, Level 6. Luke Dixon. Alice Druitt. Bradley Lightfoot. Thanks, Rachel. If we can ask Reza and Naya Tolahi to come up, please. Reza's going to present parchments for the New Zealand Diploma in Engineering Level 6. There are three strands to this program, and the first batch of graduates have completed the civil engineering strand. Stephanie Da Silva Santana Leonard. Shanti alias Sahib Singh Duel. Gregory Kendrick. Crystal Mahi. Navjot Singh. Navdeet Singh. Daniel Taggart. Completing the electrical engineering strand of the New Zealand Diploma in Engineering, Shivam Bari. Juan Brasal. Libby Munro. Jeshua Oram. And graduating with the mechanical engineering strand of the New Zealand Diploma in Engineering, Samuel Clark. Lahiru Mabutuwana Vitanangi. Luis Carlos Franco de Camargo Filho. Akil Panam Parambil Mohandas. Rohan Patak. Dixit Sharma. Amandeep Singh. Prabhjot Singh. Thank you, Reza. If I could ask Carl Harrison to come up. Carl's going to present parchments for the New Zealand Certificate in Electrical Engineering Theory, Level 3. First graduate, Finn Blamers. Oseas Dios Dos Santos. Ison Rehana. Kaylee Sutherland. Thank you, Carl. If I can ask Omar Martinez to come up, please. Omar is going to present parchment for New Zealand Certificate in Apiculture Level 3, more commonly known as beekeeping. Natasha Cooper. Omar is also presenting parchments for our next program, the New Zealand Certificate in Conservation Operations Level 4. Arthur Lena Bibby. Zara Fenn. Thank you, Omar. If I could ask James Redwood and Mohammed Hamon to come up. The first qualification is a combined qualification, the New Zealand Certificate in Primary Operational Skills Infrastructure Level 3 and the New Zealand Certificate in Horticulture General Level 3. Juni Ray Bagayan. Graduating with the New Zealand Certificate in Primary Operational Skills Infrastructure Level 3, Clarence Falloon. Graduating with the New Zealand Certificate in Horticulture Fruit Production Level 3 and the New Zealand Certificate in Computing User Fundamentals Level 2, Victoria Matthews.
No, Victoria.
Apologies. New Zealand Certificate in Horticulture Fruit Production Level 3, Ariane Smith. The New Zealand Certificate in Primary Operational Skills Infrastructure Level 3 and the New Zealand Certificate in Horticulture General Level 3, Victoria Matthews. Go at this and I'll get the name right this time. Graduating with the New Zealand Certificate in Horticulture Fruit Production Level 3 and New Zealand Certificate in Computing User Fundamentals Level 2, Rebecca Lawson. Graduating with the New Zealand Certificate in Horticulture Production, Fruit Production Level 4, Richie Aru. Hamid Birdie. Thank you, James and Hamon. If I can ask Shelley Rose to present the last parchments. Thanks, Shelley. Graduating with the New Zealand Certificate in Organic Primary Production Level 4 Crop Production, Shelley Davies. Graduating with the New Zealand Certificate in Workplace Health and Safety Practice, Level 4, Jade Daniels. Congratulations, Jade. That concludes the awarding of our certificates and diplomas for today's ceremony. I'm just going to say a few closing words before we go into our closing part of our ceremony. Well, what a fantastic ceremony, and really good to see so many of you here today. Your presence is a reflection of your desire to receive your parchment and celebrate your achievement, and rightly so. Equally, we want to acknowledge the achievements of your classmates who aren't here. The demand for skills in the areas of primary industries, trades and infrastructure mean many of you and our other graduates have secured jobs and can now put those skills to good use and make a valued and meaningful contribution to those various sectors. Thank you for your participation in this momentous occasion. You should all be so proud of yourselves as we celebrate the culmination of your hard work and dedication with you. Before you leave today, as our most recent graduates and graduates of the last of 10 ceremonies we've conducted over the last 3 weeks, I want to reflect on the effort that you've put in, as we know this journey hasn't always been easy. The past few years, including last year, have been challenging to say the least. And there would have been times when your study got really difficult. Maybe you doubted yourselves and possibly want to give up. But you hung in there and persevered. You put in the extra effort, perhaps sought some help and advice from tutors, friends and family, and did whatever else it was necessary to get across the line. You made some sacrifices, you overcame some barriers, and you achieved what you set out to do. Today, you should look back on what you've accomplished with pride and consider how you've created a new world of possibilities. You've proven to yourselves you've got what it takes to succeed, and that those skills and knowledge you have will now open doors to new opportunities, be they jobs, careers, or experiences. We also need to acknowledge the people in your lives who supported you along the way. Your whānau, your friends, your tutors, and other Toi Ohomai staff, and increasingly in today's learning environment, your employers. They all believed in you, encouraged you, and pushed you to be your best. They celebrated your victories with you, helped you learn from mistakes, and stayed with you to the end. To all of the support crews here today, we thank you for all that you've done. As you leave today, not as akonga or students, but now graduates, you take with you a range of knowledge, skills and experiences you gained in your time with Toi Ohomai. You also take with you the friendships you made, the confidence to pursue your dreams and the determination to make them a reality. Let's celebrate today. It's a day to be proud of. Remember the hard work and the dedication it took, and look forward with excitement to the bright futures that await you. Before we hand over to Huia for our closing karakia, I just want to acknowledge Megan, Katie, Aroha and our events team. These guys have pulled together 10 ceremonies across 3 weeks in all corners of our regions, from Whakatane, Taupo, Tokoroa, Rotorua and here in Tauranga. Sometimes running two big events a day, others running very small events in regional venues. Thank you very much to the team, wherever they are, they're hiding in the shadows somewhere. Some excellent mahi put in, and probably a little bit of frustration along the line, and I apologise on behalf of all of us if it caused you any grief. But just put a big hand together for those team. Thank you very much. Now going to hand over to Hui. Yep, for our closing karakia. Kia ora.
Tēnā no tātou. Just a reminder, after I finish the karakia, we're going to sing a hymn, and then the staff are going to make our way down this way, to form the guard of honour for our graduates to dance their way out of the auditorium and wait for you out there. So if you could remain seated during that, we would really appreciate that. Kia ora. Kia nui tātou. Kia tau, kia tātou katoa. Te ata whai o tō tātou ariki a ihu karaiti me te aroha o te atua. Te whiwhinga tahitanga ki te wairua tapu, ake, 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 āmeni.